Namaste, please pass it on. Namaste, please pass it on. Okay, so Tai Chi, Qigong, important breathing and postures. Many a times when we are on to learning something new, or maybe we have already learned an art, or we have learned a healing modality, or we have learned something, and all of us must have experienced this sometime or the other, we feel it's not working, isn't it? Many a times this happens, and then maybe we have spent a lot of money on it, we have spent a lot of time, a lot of energy, and then it doesn't work. It doesn't work for very simple reason is, either during the time that we have gone to learn that art, we were either sleeping, okay, or our mind was not there, or we have not understood the art or the core of that art, okay, or the essence of that particular art. Many a times the same thing happens with Tai Chi and Qigong. Many a times when we meet people, we have seen people ask you, what you're doing, and I tell them, I do Tai Chi, I do Qigong, and then they will tell, hey, I also did all that slow moving, nothing happened. Okay, so you see, where was that? The Tai Chi and Qigong was limited to only slow moving. Tai Chi and Qigong is not slow moving. Okay, Tai Chi and Qigong is a lot about breathing and a lot about your posture. How are you going to create or contour your body into a posture which will open out all the meridians or energy channels in your body? And at the same time, when you have a proper posture, and then you move slowly, and you also breathe properly. There are different kinds of breathing which I will talk about. And when you breathe properly, then the benefits of Tai Chi and Qigong are there. Okay? So remember this, whenever it is Tai Chi and Qigong, it is not just somebody moving aram, say, very slowly. If you are going to move very slowly, it will surely not work. Okay? It does not work. It does not work for very simple reason, because of not a proper breathing happening within your body or your system, and not a proper posture. This is two important aspects. So that's why we have taken this up. Many a time the most simplest techniques we have shown to people. Many times after taking this simple technique also people come back to us and then it is not working. Again, why it is not big working? Not proper breathing and not proper posture. Okay, in Tai Chi and in Qigong, when we come to the breathing aspect of it, the breathing in the beginning stages has to be absolute normal breathing. There should be no regulating the breath. Okay, so no regulating the breath like we do in our in the traditional pranayama or all those things. Your breath has to be normal. How will you know your breath is normal? You will know your breath is normal when you sit somewhere quietly and let your mind follow your breathing. Okay? Let the mind follow the breathing. Don't let the mind follow ki market mein jaake achha aap us kaam lena hai. Okay? So if your mind follows achha aap us kaam lena hai, so your breathing will become achha aap us kaam. Okay? Maybe you start feeling, smelling the aroma of the mango and all that.
And what about the prices?
How about the prices? We'll come here. Yeah. We'll come to that. Yeah, and the moment you... Achha, aap us kaam, and the moment you think of the price, then you'll get a jolt and you'll open out your eyes again. Okay, because the prices are that way. The prices are all, you know what they say, a 480 current of electricity nowadays. Okay? So we don't want that 480 electricity current going through our body. So have the mind on your breathing. So sit somewhere. Now when you sit somewhere, how are you going to sit? Okay? How many of you are sitting right? Everybody is sitting wrong. Okay? Slouching, leaning. These postures that you have taken now, it is okay. When you are listening to me, you are not involved in any action. Okay? All these times, when you're sitting, maybe watching TV and all that, it is okay that you are going to be relaxed. And it's a must. It's a must. I sometimes really wish, and maybe by next month I'll be doing a very big experiment, to do meditation in whatever posture you can do your meditation. So even sitting on the chair and slouching, also you can go into meditation. Okay, that's left to be seen next month, how many people I get and how many people are ready to experiment with me. Okay, so for your leisure time, when you're watching TV, when you're listening, what is the comfort zone that you can be in? You can be in. So you can lean back, you can slouch, you can do any kind of posture on the chair. But when you are going to do your Tai Chi, or when you are going to follow your breath, then your spine, okay, your spine has to be straight. Now when you straighten your spine out, very automatically you open the rib cage out. These are your ribs. When you open the rib cage out, your lungs have space inside. They have easy space to expand and contract. Not only the lungs, the diaphragm has space to move upwards and downwards. And so the rest of the organs are released. But if you slouch and you're sitting like this, or you're sitting like this, very few organs that are there in the body, you are putting pressure on it. So if you're going to put pressure on the organs, then you cannot follow your breath. You will never be able to make out what is your breathing pattern. Okay? And it is very important in exercises like yoga, pranayama, and qigong, and tai chi, and all the breathing exercises. Why only these? All the exercises, even weightlifting, even bodybuilding, even aerobics, you have to know the rhythm of your breathing. We all of us have a rhythm of breath. All our breathing cannot be done at one time. If I start doing anulom vilom over here and I say everybody right nostril in, everybody cannot take right nostril in at the same time. Somebody will leave it even before I say in. Why that is happening is because we all have a pattern, a breathing pattern, a breathing rhythm. It is very important that you know this. Okay? When you know this proper rhythm of your own breath, then you can apply it to your Tai Chi and Qigong very well. All of you over here know, when you are doing your Tai Chi, when you are doing your Qigong, in certain moves you have to inhale and the very next move you have to exhale. Sometimes some movements in Tai Chi and Qigong, the inhalation movements are smaller, the exhalation movements are longer. And sometimes the inhalation movements are longer, exhalations are shorter. But then you have to harmonize it. Okay? Now when you harmonize this, then there is a very high level of benefit that you get in your Tai Chi and your Qigong. Very simply is because of the lungs expanding to take in extra oxygen. Whenever there is extra oxygen to your body, that means you are doing a proper healing which is happening to your body. Or rather, to put it, not go too much into medical terms, each and every cell in your body always needs a certain amount of oxygen, and not only oxygen, it needs a certain amount of fresh oxygen. So to get fresh oxygen, you have to have a breath to the full lung capacity, not half lung or quarter lung. Most of you now who are sitting here, you are a breathing ear. आधा से ज़्यादा जिन्होंने ज़्यादा खाना खा के आया, यू आर ब्रीदिंग एयर. दैट इज़ यू आर फीलिंग योर ब्रीदिंग एयर. एक्चुअली ऑन दिस इज द फूड इनसाइड व्हिच इज कमिंग अप एंड गोइंग डाउन बिकॉज देयर इज नो प्लेस टू गो. ओके, यू हैव टू फील योर ब्रेथ मूविंग डाउन टू द नेवल, फ्रॉम द नेवल टू दिस एरिया. ओके, द लोअर एब्स एज वी कॉल इट इन द चाइनीज लैंग्वेज, यू कॉल इट द दांतियान. That's why it is always called dantian breathing. Some people call it belly breathing. Okay? Now when we say belly breathing, it is just said belly breathing. It doesn't mean that you have to breathe inside your belly. You cannot breathe inside your stomach. Okay? You can breathe only inside your lungs. It is a movement of the lungs and the diaphragm which put pressure onto your belly which moves or protrudes out just a little, and that's why it's called belly breathing. Okay, so whenever you are going to inhale, you have to feel the area from the navel and below the navel slightly moving out, and as you exhale it slightly moves in. We will try this breathing after some time. I'm sure most of you all must have had your food now and come. If you not have your food early, some of you must have had nasta and come also. So we will wait for that to get digested and we'll try. So proper breathing, so proper expansion of the organs will give proper massaging of the internal organs, which will bring in healing or good health to you. Okay, so the posture is always straight, spine straight but not tight. I've seen many times, not only in our classes, in our yoga and in the Qigong classes, also in yoga class, whenever the teacher or the instructor will say keep your spine erect, automatically everybody becomes soldiers. This is not spine erect. Okay, to keep your spine erect there are many ways. You should feel your spine straight, and at the same time you have to feel relaxed, whether you are doing the exercise or the breathing sitting, or you are doing your exercise standing. Relaxation will give you an awareness of your breathing rhythm. If you are tensed, your breathing will become hyper and you will not get a proper rhythm of your breathing. What is the rhythm of the breathing? Is how many seconds you inhale, how many seconds you exhale. How many seconds you inhale, and if there is a pause and then an exhalation, that is one rhythm. The other rhythm is inhale, exhale at once, and then there is a pause. For other people, there is inhale, exhale, and then there is a pause. There are different kinds of breathing rhythm. This is, you have to be aware and recognize your own breath, your own rhythm. Okay, this is very important. Once you know this, then you will know many things about yourself. Okay, now when we say many things about ourselves, we will know why there is no happiness in our life. When you know the breath rhythm, you will know why there is a lot of sadness in life. You will know why you are not successful. You will know why you are not financially rich. It's all on your breathing and your posture. Okay, very simple example, let me tell you. If none of you know me and you are going to come for a class or a talk, Tai Chi Qigong, important breathing and posture, none of you have ever seen me, and I would open this door and come like this, would you tell me I'm a teacher? No. But if I would open the door and walk in like this, looking at each one of you, and come straight to the table here and keep staring at you, then you would all be aware this is somebody, isn't it? So posture is so important. Okay, if I keep my hand at the back and keep talking to you, you will not enjoy the talk much. Anybody who is into human behavior will say iska pas kuch chupane ka, isliye dono haath piche rakha hai. Okay, it works, it's a fact. That's how human behavior sometimes work. It's not right always, it's just 50-50. Okay, now when I talk to you, all of you, if you see my videos, you will see my hand always goes up. I always do this when I show you energy, because I'm so confident of what I'm saying. I always do this because I'm very confident of what I'm saying. So posture again is very important. I stand straight. I'm always straight in my spine when I'm talking. Okay, my hands are always round and it is out. I'm not like this. I don't talk like this. I talk like this to people. Doesn't my posture say a lot about me then? And that is because the right posture is there. And when I deliver my lecture with that confidence that I have, and you receive it in that way. Now, how does the posture build up and why am I so confident? It's because I know the rhythm of my breathing. Okay? So, we'll all also try to get the rhythm of our breathing. Once you get the rhythm of your breathing, then you will know and then you will see how much of a difference it makes. And then the same posture and rhythm you use into your daily life, into your Tai Chi, into your Qigong, and then you will see the benefits will be within the click of our finger. Whether you are doing healing for yourself, whether you are doing distance healing, or whether you are dealing with the most, what you say, gravest problem of your life which nobody can solve. Proper posture, proper breathing will change the whole situation. It will not only tell a lot about you, but it also tell you a lot about the people who you are going around with, going about with, people of your own stature, your society, even relatives, even friends. Okay? So this breathing and the posture is so very, very important. This is what actually gives you the benefit of Tai Chi and Qigong very fast. Okay? So never ever think Tai Chi and Qigong is just that slow movement. First class slow music lagaya, chalo, everybody is doing Tai Chi, Qigong, Shibashi. Karne wale ko bhi maza aya, dekhne wale ko bhi maza aya, chalo, go home. When you try it out, nothing happens. Okay, nothing happens is because the breathing was not there, the posture was not there, what you actually had to have. Okay, so let's start. We'll start by doing a little belly breathing. Now, we'll all try to remain a little straight. Okay, first you could just watch. I will show you. Basically, this is your spine. Most of us, this is the state of our spine. Most of us. Even if you touch like that, no, you make somebody touch, you will see. From this area, it is in, like this. Okay? Shoulder blade. From this area, it is out. This area, again it is in. This area, again it is out. Okay? Some scientist, neurologist tell you this is the actual shape of the spine that has to be. Okay? In Tai, they may be right. They surely may be right. I'm not a neurosurgeon or not a scientist or not a spine specialist. They may be right. But then again, according to Tai Chi and Qigong, according to yoga, your spine from this point to your hip joint has to be straight for benefits of healing, for benefits of health. You go to any yoga class, you go to any Qigong class, the very first thing that you have to learn is straightening your spine. It is seen many a times when the spine is in this shape, sometimes it is in this shape, okay, sometimes it is in this shape. Whenever the spine is in these kinds of shapes, it is seen many a times, a little extra pressure on the spine can actually injure the spine. And we all of us know, if there is a spine injury, God bless that person. Again, because of certain studies that we all have. Sometimes it's so sad to know. Our medical fraternity is reading 100-year-old books and trying to heal us now with the same books. So if this was wrong and this was right or this was right, then why in certain exercises, not today, but 5,000 year old in Tai Chi and Qigong and some more 1,000 years old in Pranayam, we were in yoga and Pranayam, we had to be having a straight spine. Isn't it? If this was right, we never had to do this. There was no need. So the very fact and the need is trying to keep your spine erect. It is very important. Okay, now why is it very important? We all know our body is made up of a lot of nervous systems. So there is a lot of nerve traffic way. Okay, we have a lot of nerves passing up and down throughout our body to the tip of the finger, nails, to your hair. Okay, And all of them, again, not to talk in serious medical terms, but just for the layman, all these nervous system come into the spine. Okay, you know, we all have vertebrae like this. Okay, even this is not the actual photo. Okay, we all have, this is something like a spine, and all the nerves pass through these. Okay, now whenever you are in a wrong posture here and there, there is pressure on these nerves. If there is pressure on the nerves, there is less blood flowing to the brains. If there is less blood flowing to the brain, it does not function properly. And you know the whole system, walking, eating, thinking, dancing, crying, joy, happiness, is connected here. Okay? So only when this is in a straight line and the nerves passing through this will be able to be straight. If it is curved, then even the nervous system will have pressure. And many of you know about herniated spine, about spondylosis, and so many other sicknesses of the spine, and the doctor will tell you degenerative disease. That means slowly you will be actually murdering your own self. So this is very important, that your spine be straight on the physical level. Again, on the spiritual level, on the healing level, on the energy level, again, you talk about meridians, and we all know there are plenty of meridians on our body, plenty of energy paths. We talk about two paths in Tai Chi and Qigong for now. Okay, so one is which moves from your dantian, moves at the back, goes up over your head and stops above your teeth. Okay, the other one starts at the tip of the tongue and moves back again down to the dantian. So when you are going to do a breathing with your tongue up, it travels from here to here and from here to the dantian. So there is a continuous circulation of energy happening again, which can bring you healing. So this has nothing to do with the nervous system, but now some people say that the meridians are the energy body or the aura of the nervous system. Okay, so if your spine and the nervous system in the spine is crooked, even the aura is crooked and hurt, right? So now all of you have got an idea why the spine has to be straight. And there is a very simple exercises when you can do that to get your spine straight. Every day, whenever you're sitting, standing, just little while, if you try to do this, you will achieve this position of having a straight spine, though it is sometimes very difficult. It is difficult, but it is possible. Who will find it difficult? All of us who are injured on the spine, all of us who are a little old, okay? All of us who are very lazy, all of us who say, "Arey, jaane de, marne de, jaisa hai, waisa achcha hai," all those people will find it difficult. But if you intend to have good health, then you will surely make it possible. Is that right? So first we will try to, as you are sitting, don't change your posture. As you are sitting, we'll try to see whether we are really breathing to the full capacity of your lungs. There are many ways to check it. Okay? First we will start only by keeping your hand at the side of the ribs. Okay? And we will breathe in and out, normal breathing, don't regulate, don't try to do this, okay? Just keep your hand and just bring your mind to your breathing. Don't change your posture. Sab logon ne apna posture change kiya. Jaisa baitha tha, aisa baith jao aaram se. Relax. So you will know between wrong posture breathing and the right posture breathing. So don't worry. Now you breathe normally and you see what is happening. Have awareness on your palms, okay, and just see what happens. If you tell me they are becoming warm, I will ask you from 1 to 10 how much it is becoming warm. If you are feeling uncomfortable, I will ask you how much you are feeling uncomfortable from 1 to 10. You have to grade it between 1 and 10. Whatever you are feeling, whatever your awareness is, remember you are going to grade it from 1 to 10 for your own self. Okay? Fine. Anybody wants to say what you were feeling when you kept your palms here? Nobody?
Warmness.
Very good. Anybody else? Sweating on your palms. That is because you had it close. So everybody were feeling warmness. Is it right that you feel warm? Or is it wrong? Nobody knows? We will come through that later. Whether warm is okay or whether not warm or rather normal is okay. Okay. So everybody felt that. Anything else you felt? Nobody felt anything.
Movement of muscle.
So movement of muscle, you can grade it from 1 to 10. What is the grading? What you would say from 1 to 10?
7.
Warmness, how much you can grade all those who are feeling warm? How much? 1 to 10?
5.
Okay. So you just remember that grading. Okay, you just remember that way. Right?
I felt very peaceful.
You also felt very peaceful. Okay. Right? So now, let's try a little bit of another way of breathing. Now let's keep our hand just below the navel. Both our hands very lightly. Any posture you had, just keep on with it. Don't try to straighten your spine. Then we will know the difference. Okay? Now once again, normal breathing. Don't force your breath. Absolute normal breathing. And again become aware. If there is warmness, if muscles are moving, what is happening, just become aware of it. Okay? Anybody?
Movement.
Yeah. How many felt movement?
Movement.
Okay. First, okay. If you feel movement, तो दो तरीका का movement होता है. एक वो movement होता है जो पेट में अभी गुड़गुड़ gas होता है. वो नहीं होता है. So और दूसरा ये movement होता है कि पेट expand होके contract होता है. All of you felt that expanding and contraction. To what grade you can give it? From 1 to 10? 4, 5. Very good. Keep it in mind. Anybody else? Iske alawa, anybody else felt something different?
Release of tension in the body.
Release of tension in the body. Again, you can grade it up to?
3. Right.
3? Just 3.
Yes. Being a short.
Okay.
I didn't feel much movement of the stomach. I just feel
the energy. Okay. Now we will try to get into a posture. Okay. Now we will try to slightly come to the edge of your chest. And try to keep your back straight naturally. Okay, see if you can keep your hand at the back. Now when you keep your hand at the back, when you are sitting, see that this part is straight, there should be no curve here down. Okay, if you can keep your hand up here, see that this is not like this out. See, it is straight. If you can keep your hand at the back, this also should be straight. Okay, see that you can feel it. If you cannot feel, if you feel that the spine is straight, there is no curve, just keep your hand in the front and maintain that posture. Now you, when you are sitting straight, you are having your spine straight, you should not feel any tightness anywhere. If you are feeling any tightness anywhere when your spine is straight, that means there is something wrong with your spine or your spine is not straight. Okay? So you maintain that posture, relaxed manner. It should not be that you are holding like this. Okay? Now we will keep our hands back again here. Still maintain the straight spine. If the spine turns little also, you will not get this. Again, with your spine straight. Okay. Now once again, we will do your breathing. One or two normal breaths. And again, you will tell me what is happening. And again, you will grade it. Normal breathing. Just keep your mind and you have to just wait and see. Breathing will happen automatically. Okay, hands down. Now this breathing, grade it first from 1 to 10. Grading in movement, in warmness. First, let's say warmness. How many of you had felt warmness previously? Did you feel warm again now?
No.
No. That means if you're feeling warm when you're breathing, it is wrong. You're not breathing in fresh energy, not breathing in fresh oxygen. Okay? Now, how many of you found muscles moving?
Yes.
Okay? Now, how much could you grade it, sir? You
6, 7?
5, 6. Anybody else? Those who did not feel moving of the muscles first, did you feel muscle moving now?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay, so you see how different it is by just keeping the spine straight. When you're keeping a spine straight, there is a lot of space created. Your lung gets to expand and contract. The more it expands, the more it will bring in fresh oxygen. Okay, let's go down now to the dantian. Same posture. Keep your back straight.
The breathing was rhythmic.
Yes. Keep your spine straight. And keep your palm lightly below the navel. Remember, not on the navel. Below the navel. Try to keep your spine straight. See what happens is, now when you're sitting and you have to reach below your navel, very automatically you will stretch your spine. Okay? Now once again on the breathing, and then see what happens. Once again, just normal breathing. Keep your mind on your breath. Okay, fine. Now tell me, many of you all felt this moving in the first time also, when you were sitting anyhow. Now when you sat in the spine straight posture, how many of you feel this is more movement? Slightly more. You graded from 1 to 10. Did it, you can grade it more than the previous one, or it is less?
2 points
higher, sir? Very good. So the breath has also become longer.
Longer.
Breath is longer, yeah? Yeah, so you will feel that. Okay, some people will feel the movement more profound, more solid. Some will feel clear kind of breathing happening.
Yes.
Movement will be less. Like I said, see, because we all have different rhythms in breathing. Everybody cannot sit over here and go, I will say, inhal, anulom, vilom, yahan se le lo. यहाँ से छोड़ दो, यहाँ से ले लो, सब एक साथ में नहीं सांस ले सकते. अगर हम सभी लोग एक साथ में सांस ले सकते बराबर, everybody's inhalation, exhalation, leave the world, here in this room, in this very room, if we can all inhale and exhale at one time, and the pause happening at one time, you know what will happen? हम सभी के सभी लोग संत कहलाएंगे, हमारे कुंडलिनी जागृत हो जाएगी. So this can never happen. So teaching breathing for everybody, one kind of a breathing style, hazaro admi, it does not work. It does not work. You have to know your own rhythm, isn't it? We are all living different kinds of lives. Are we all engineers? Are we all working in one company? No. Are the color of our skin same? Different. We look different. You talk differently. Why? Because each one, your breath will show you a lot about yourself. Okay? So now you know the importance of the straightening of the spine. So you should try your best to keep your spine straight and relaxed whenever you can. Half of your healing battle, half of your troubles in life is won by keeping the spine straight. Many a times there are courses, okay? There are courses, kundalini jagrut karne ki courses, okay? People come, they want their kundalini to be awakened. There are courses, bahut kuch hota hai usme, maine kafi jagah pe dekha. I have gone to so many of these classes, so many of these gurus who do all this kundalini jagrut, shakti path and all that, okay? When the spine is straight, that's what happens. Okay? When your spine is straight, proper breathing rhythm, then the kundalini is activated. Now the kundalini is a creation by the almighty energy, wherever it is, up, down, at the side of me, at the back of me, or sitting on the last row. The kundalini is a creation of that omnipresent energy. So, if the kundalini is activated, you will not start dancing like a mad fellow, like it happens in so many courses. You will not start screaming and shouting. You will not start laughing like a mad person. You will not start crying like a mad person. You will not start puking like a mad person, like I have seen in so many other places. Not to judge them. They may be doing it right. According to my study, when the kundalini is awakened, you become peaceful. You become blissful. You become full of wisdom. You don't act mad. You don't puke. Because the very fact of making your spine straight, the effort that you put in keeping your spine straight and bringing the breath, the rhythm of your breath with the straight spine is a cleansing effect which goes out very calmly in a relaxed manner. Okay? So don't fall for this. किसी ने आके सिर पे हाथ लगाया उसका डांस चालू हो जाता है कोई उल्टी उल्टा सुल्टा होता है कोई क्या क्या करता है आई हैव सीन दिस हैपनिंग एवरीवे एंड व्हाई आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस इज बिकॉज आई हैव सीन व्हेन आई हैव गॉन टू दिस प्लेसेस मैंने बहुत सारे जगह पे गया लेट मी गिव यू एन एग्जांपल आई विल नॉट नेम द टीचर वेल नोन टीचर सबको हाथ लगा दे जाने का सबके मस्तक पे हाथ लगा दे सबका किसी का डांस चालू किसी का झूमना चालू किसी का रोना चालू किसी का हंसना चालू क्या हुआ है कुंडलिनी जागृत होते जैसा है वैसा रहने दो कोर्स ओवर बाय द इवनिंग टाइम डांस बंद हो गया हंसना बंद हो गया रोना बंद हो गया सब लोग हम लोग बाहर आ गए सब अपने अपनी गाड़ी ढूंढते हैं जिसके पास गाड़ी थी वो गाड़ियाँ से जाएगी जिनको ट्रेन से जाना है वो ट्रेन से जाएगी उस इंसान जिसका कुंडलिनी जागृत होता है क्या आपको ऐसा लगता है कि उसके कुछ चीज़ का फिक्र होगा अगर मेरी कुंडलिनी अगर जागृत होती है वैसे कोर्स में जब मैं बाहर आऊँ क्या आपको ये लगता है कि मुझे फिक्र है कि मुझे टैक्सी मिलेगी या ट्रेन में बड़ा लाइन होगा टिकट लेने के लिए होगा नहीं मैंने वो लोगों को देखा जो अंदर झूम और डांस रहता है चलो रे यार जल्दी जाएगा ट्रेन का टिकट के लिए बड़ा लाइन होगा शाम है संडे है तो जिसका कुंडलिनी जागृत होता है वो एक मामूली टिकट के लिए सोचेगा डू यू थिंक सो डोंट फॉल फॉर दिस कुंडलिनी थिंग In the 24-hour cycle of our life, if you can always keep your spine straight and know the rhythm of your breathing, in every hour of the 24-hour, there is 1 second where your kundalini is activated on its own. This nobody will tell you, I am telling you. This is the secret of the Himalayan masters. I will tell you this. That's why teachers go to the Himalayas. Because here you cannot be aware in this crowd, in this noise. You cannot be aware of the energy rising up and down. That's why they go there. And in the 24-hour cycle, sometimes they sit without food, without water. Is to accumulate each and every hour of that kundalini getting awakened. And that's why when they come back, they are enlightened people, then they don't think ki local train ka bada line hoga ticket lena hai ya mai ghar kaisa jayega bahut zor se barish aaya. Okay, so now you know the importance of keeping the spine straight. Okay, sometimes instead of teaching you in the Chinese way, the Indian way is more powerful. Okay, so just to show you how powerful Tai Chi and Qigong is, I always use the Indian culture in it. Okay. So constantly when your breathing is proper and your posture is straight and you do your Tai Chi movement, you do your forms concentrated and slowly, then you are inducing the jagrut of the kundalini every time you are moving. Every time you are moving, you are blissful. Every time you are moving, you are calm. So in 1 hour, 1 second instead of the kundalini getting awakened, if you are doing your Tai Chi and your Qigong properly, then you are awakening your kundalini continuously. And can you imagine, if you can do it on your own, how much of benefit you may be getting? Otherwise, you will have to wait and see, abhi wo ek second kab aayega. और वो एक सेकंड आने के लिए आप इतना सोचोगे, इतना स्ट्रेस होगा कि वो आके चला भी जाएगा आपको पता भी नहीं चलेगा. ओके, दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई पीपल गो टू द हिमालयस, बिकॉज इट्स क्वाइट, इट्स एम्प्टी, एवरी मूवमेंट इन द बॉडी इज हर्ड, राइट. सो प्रॉपर पोस्चर ऑफ द स्पाइन एंड प्रॉपर ब्रीदिंग. नाउ लेट्स डू समथिंग विच इज कॉल्ड बेली ब्रीदिंग और दांतियान ब्रीदिंग. इफ यू डू एब्सोल्युटली नथिंग, डोंट डू एनी आसना, डोंट डू एनी प्राणायाम, डोंट डू एनी ताइची, एनी चीगोंग पोस्चर. इफ यू कैन डू प्रॉपर दांतियान ब्रीदिंग, यू कैन क्योर हंड्रेड्स ऑफ योर डिजीजेस. एंड व्हेन आई से डिजीजेस, आई टॉक अबाउट सीरियस प्रॉब्लम्स, साइकोलॉजिकल प्रॉब्लम्स, नर्वस प्रॉब्लम्स, स्केलेटल प्रॉब्लम्स, वॉट एवर यू नेम इट, ऑर्गेनिक प्रॉब्लम्स इन योर बॉडी. ओनली बेली ब्रीदिंग और दांतियान ब्रीदिंग हैज सच powerful kind of energy transmission in it, right? So what is belly breathing is? Many ways to do it. In the beginning, you first we will check. Now most of you have done this. How many of you felt when you inhale, your palm which was below the navel moving out? Yeah. Okay, most of you felt that, yeah. Right? Most of us do Tai Chi, Qigong, who have done Pranayam, who have done any other breathing meditation, very easily will know this. Okay, so this moves out when you inhale and it moves in when you exhale. Moves out when you inhale and moves in when you exhale. Okay, how you will know this? When you lie down, you can lie down on a bench or on your bed and you keep a book on your stomach. So when you inhale, the book will slightly rise up. When you exhale, the book will move down. Now belly breathing, dantian breathing doesn't end there. Now when you are doing this breathing, your diaphragm is here. This is your sternum bone, this is your ribs. This area should not move extra. If this is moving like this, then it is wrong. This movement should be minimum. This movement down should be maximum. Okay? So now we will try this. So one palm below the dantian, one palm on the chest. Again, keep your posture, have your spine straight, absolute straight line, and relaxed also. And now once again start your breathing and see whether automatically this is moving out and in. The below palm or the bottom palm of the dantian should be moving more than the palm on the chest. Start. Okay, everybody could feel this?
Yes.
Less movement of the upper arm. All those who are practicing some breathing art will feel this movement less, this movement extra. Now how will you know you are doing abdomen breathing or belly breathing or dantian breathing accurately? Okay, now you will slightly come to the edge of your chest. When you do this, again you will keep your spine straight. First you will keep one palm in the front. Okay, just below the navel. Remember, don't keep up here. If you keep up here, there is surely going to be movement and you will get everything wrong. It should be below the navel and you start your breathing. Okay, and you see if the palm is moving forward when you inhale, inward when you exhale. After that, very slowly you take your other palm and you keep it exactly on the back. Okay, but don't bend forward, keep your posture. इसलिए पहले से अपना posture ठीक से करवाइए. So when you putting your hand at the back, again your spine should be straight. And when you inhale, both the palms should move out. And when you exhale, both the palms should move in. If that is happening, then you are doing proper dantian breathing. your breathing is right. Okay, first only in the front, everybody remove your hands on the back. First only in the front, start. I will tell you when to keep your hand at the back. Okay, first only one palm in the front. Do not do forceful breathing. Don't force your breath into your stomach. This will give you gastric problems. It should go automatically. Now keep the other hand exactly at the back. Keep your spine straight. Normal breathing. And now you check. When you inhale, both the palms should move outwards. When you exhale, both the palms you should feel me moving inwards. Okay, keep your hands down. Now how many of you could feel this happening? Both the palms moving. How many? Let's see, haath upar karo, jaisa gine to kitne logon ko hota hai. Very good. Very good.
Front is more than the back.
3 to 4.
Front is more than.
Movement is right, backside, but movement.
Very slight. Very slight. Very slight. Yes. Yes. Yeah, you can make out. Very slight. Okay, so.
Heat, I feel
the heat is more. Anybody else feel the heat is more? No? अभी मैंने पहले बोला इसलिए छुपाओ मत बोल दो यू विल लर्न व्हेन यू टेल मी ओके नो नॉट देयर इन द बॉडी ओके या नो द हीट इन द बॉडी शुड बी लेस ऑलवेज रिमेंबर ब्रीदिंग शुड ऑलवेज बी वेरी शैलो एंड ईजिली इफ देर इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन समवेयर देन दे विल इट विल क्रिएट हीट इन द बॉडी ओके So this is belly breathing, or some people call it abdomen breathing, some people call it dantian breathing. And like I said, you can cure a lot of disease only doing this for 5 minutes a day. You can do it sitting, you can do it standing, and you can also do it lying down. Instead, when you do it lying down, it is more effective because naturally your spine is straight. Sitting mein, standing mein thoda bahut kabhi kabhi. Automatically we make our spine crooked. Now belly breathing will not stop only here, because when you breathe in, only these two parts don't go out, even this part moves out. Okay, so now what we will do, for some breaths we will keep our hand like this, okay, and without shaking too much. If you shake too much, you will lose the breath. Keeping the breath normal, slowly move the hand also here, and again see if the same effect what is here is also happening at this side. Okay, come on, let's try it. So now we are doing front and back, normal breathing. Let's start at the left and right side. Keep both your palms to the left of your body and right, just above the waist joint. Your small finger should be on the waist bone or the hip bone. The rest of the palms on the soft area above the hip bone. Okay, release your hands down. Now how many could find this happening?
Yes.
Everybody, most of you? Very nice. So every day you could just take out 5 minutes to do this in this manner. Having a spine erect and straight, but relaxed and normal breathing, no regulating the breath. That will cure plenty of diseases in your body. Not only that, it will make your mind also calm. You will be able to focus on things properly. You will be concentrated and you will not be irritated. And if energy willing or God willing, maybe your kundalini will also be awakened. Next class, instead of me being over here, you will be here, I will be sitting there. Okay, no, it's possible. Okay? Yeah.
It's actually very hot before we did the front and
back.
It was almost uneasy.
Uh-huh.
And after we did this, very cool.
Very cool, yes. Remember this. This is a very important point. Whenever you are doing this breathing, internally you should feel cool. If internally some area of the body you feel warm, there is some disharmony. Okay, disharmony is always an ailment or problem, but not ki aisa problem hai jo solve nahi hoga. Okay, why that it happens is, even if you are breathing in the fresh universal oxygen, fresh universal air or prana, whatever you call it, even though you are breathing that in which is fresh, but the moment it enters here, first it enters your energy body, it carries all the impurities of your energy body. Then it goes in, it starts to carry all the energies of your physical body. And it goes through your whole body into your bloodstream. Okay? Then you will feel that warmness. That's why sometimes see, even if you are out in a cool or a cold winter climate outside, you will still feel your breath warm. Okay? And there's no worry about it, about this impurities coming into your body, there is absolute no worry. Okay? Because it is ours. Jo bhi hai, apna hi hai. Achha hai, wo bhi apna hai. Bura hai, wo bhi apna hi hai. Kisi aur ka nahi aayega. Okay? So, next time you find your this breath becoming warm, aray, sir ne toh aisa bola. So, don't worry. Your own impurities will be circulating in your body. But you keep doing the exercise. You keep doing your breathing properly, spine erect, that will change. You will feel very cool and calm when you do that. Okay? So, you did the posture sitting. Lying down is very easy. Very important in Tai Chi and Qigong is, most of the exercise in Tai Chi and Qigong is always recommended standing. So, now we will stand and try to get the spine straight. So, first you guys sit down. I will show you what to do. So, whenever you stand, the moment you stand in Tai Chi and Qigong, it is always keeping the toes and heels in a straight line. Okay? Distance between both the feet are shoulder distance or beyond the shoulder. Slightly bend the knee. Now when you take this posture, I will do it like this sideways so everybody can see. Now the moment you do this, you feel over your back, on the lower back above the waist, you will see it is inside. Okay? So, when you check the lower back, it will be like this. Okay, it will be here. When you check up here on the shoulder blade, it will be out. When you check here, it will be in. Again, what I mentioned first. Some say this is a natural posture. Again, if it was natural posture, we would have been the most healthiest people. Why? It is because, again, previously it was only known to people who are into alternative therapies, okay, traditional Chinese medicine. I was reading somewhere and I came to know that even in the old ancient days when our rishis used to do Ayurveda, even in the Ayurveda they would diagnose or cases or get healing done on the spine, because whatever will happen, any ailment in any organ of your body, in your stomach, in your chest, your heart, whatever happens over here will affect the spine. So if you are having heart trouble here, sometimes the doctor will ask you if your back is paining or not, because it affects here. And sometimes ulta ho jata hai. For some reason you hurt your spine, accident, fall. And if you get hurt somewhere here on your spine, it will affect the organs here. Indigestion or some gallbladder problems or anything. Okay, so you see how important the spine is. So if the naturally the spine was like that, and it was, we would not have any kind of sickness. Now to actually fight the sickness and do proper breathing, we have to make our spine straight. So that means a straight spine is more healthier than this natural shape of the spine. Okay, so when you are going to stand like this in this posture of Tai Chi and Qigong, this is the shape of your spine. You have to try to get it like this. Okay, straight line. So I hope everybody can see this. So the moment you are here, this is here, watch this area. From here you keep your hand down and you slightly move in front, move this whole pelvic slightly in front, and then you see the curvature where you will go. Now here you just hang your hands down, you should not hold it like this. So your chest or your shoulder should move backward. Moving backward doesn't mean like this, this is wrong. Moving backward means moving the shoulder down, and the top of the head you should feel moving up in a straight line. So this is your posture. When you do this, your spine will become absolutely straight. Okay, let's all of us try stand up and try to check your own spine and see whether you can get this properly. So distance between your feet, remember toes and heels straight line, very important. Knee slightly bent, and now you check with your hand. First check the lower back. If it is there, the curve is here, keep your hand down on the tailbone, slightly push the tailbone forward, and again feel, see if it is straight. Then come up to the neck and try pushing your head upward, very relaxed, and feel your shoulder stretching downward. Okay, if you feel you have got it, now keep your palm on the dantian and one palm at the back on the tailbone and concentrate on your breathing. Now if you feel both your hands are moving in and out, that means on inhalation both the palms will move out, on exhalation both the palms will move in. If this is happening very strongly and magnified, you can feel the front and the back palm moving out and in, then your spine is erect and straight, you are doing proper breathing and proper posture. Those who cannot close your eyes, you can keep your eyes open also and do this. Okay, hands down. Everybody could get this?
Yes.
Has it changed from sitting to standing?
Yes.
Standing me aur alag pata chalta? Very good. Sit down. I will do again, we will just do one more thing now. We will see more how breathing and straight posture can make a difference. Anybody over here who has problem in digesting food or not? Anybody?
Fairly I have problem.
No, no, now, now. Okay, let's try. She has frequent constipation, but let's see if it works for her. Come. Okay, very simple, we will see. I always do this. Again, it is known by many names. Kinesiology, muscle testing, I call it energy testing. Because what everything is energy. So first we will slightly do an energy testing and we will see. And then with the breathing and posture, just for a few moments, we'll see if it makes a difference or no. Okay, see, it all depends on her. She is doing her own Qigong. As a Qigong teacher, I will do nothing for her now. We will see how much you can do for your own self. So, actually constipation has many problems. Sometimes the constipation has nothing to do with the tummy or the intestines. Sometimes the constipation has something to do with the spine. Sometimes the constipation has something to do with the mind. Okay, so even then, we will just try out one thing. First is, we'll ask her to keep her hand up. You don't have any injury on your hand, right? I will push downward, you will push it upwards. Okay, use your strength, push, push, very good. Okay, so quite, there's an effort that I have to do. Keep your hand down. Keep your hand on your stomach. Okay, keep your hand up. This is how energy works. So if something is wrong here, when I'm doing energy testing, it will not work. Okay, right? Are you ready? I will push down. You will push up. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, push up. So her constipation is definitely to do with something with a stomach. Okay, so many ways. Now you try to keep your back straight. Check the curvature. Make it straight. Okay, keep your palm now on the dantya. Do belly breathing very coolly and calmly. Just do the belly breathing. Okay, if you want, you can feel your whole stomach contracting and expanding, contracting and expanding. Feel the intestine contracting and expanding, contracting and expanding. Feel the gallbladder also contracting and expanding, and normal breathing. Okay, it's too fast, but we will check now. Keep your hand down. Once again, keep your hand here. Keep this hand up. Okay, I will push down. You will push up. Okay, once again. Previously, we seen when I did that, she could not keep her hand up. Okay, ready? Push, push, push. Okay, little strength. We will do it again. Once again, rub your palm. We will put external chi in it. Rub the palm. Okay, keep it here. Keep the warmness here. Once again, keep your spine straight. Once again, do that same. When you inhale, feel the tummy expanding. When you exhale, feel it contracting, feel it becoming loose. Same feel with your large intestine, same feel with your small intestine. Okay, open your eyes, keep your hand out, shake your hands out. Okay, once again, keep that palm here. I will push down, you will push up. Okay, ready? You see, more effort. You feel this change?
Yes.
So, you can cure yourself with proper posture, proper breathing. Each time you realize that your spine is crooked, you make it straight, whatever you are doing. Walking, talking, standing at the bus stop. अपने क्या है ना साल अपने को style मारने का बहुत गंदी आदत है. Will see anybody? दूसरा कोई रहेगा कोई मिल गया. Can you imagine thousands of times you are moving your spine in all the directions you can. How much of injury the spine must be taking, and the why? Of the injury on the spine may be transferred to the organ. Many a times you may be a healthy person, eating healthy, drinking healthy, thinking healthy. Phir bhi kabhi kabhi kuch hota hai, pata hai? You must have seen so many people who don't drink, liver problem. Log bolta hai, daru to pita hai, usse acha apu ne apun pike bhi hatta katta hai. You must have heard this. Daru pine wale ke patent rehte hai. Usko dekho, daru ne pita, uska liver kharab ho gaya. Why? It is many a times because of your posture. And not proper breathing. So, whenever you do Tai Chi and Qigong, all those who are practicing now, Tai Chi and Qigong, remember, goes without saying, Tai Chi and Qigong is not just moving slowly. Everybody who thinks Tai Chi and Qigong is moving slowly, you are wrong. Constantly you are keeping your spine erect and straight and also relaxed. Many a times when you want our spine to be straight, we again tense our whole body. And breathing should be proper. Dantiyan breathing. Okay? One more easy method of doing Dantiyan breathing is using the power of your mind. Not only those can use the mind whose mind is really powerful. Because mind powerful bana nahi sakte hum log. You cannot make your mind powerful. Anybody knows why? Nobody knows why you cannot make your mind powerful? Nobody? Pardon?
There is no mind.
There is no? God bless you, sir. अगर ये बात अगर सही होगा तो पूछो
नहीं.
Mind is not in control. Anybody
running
else?
Here and there.
Running here and there, yes.
Everywhere.
You cannot make your mind powerful because your mind is already powerful. Your mind already has tremendous amount of power. The only thing is you are constantly वो चलता है attitude. मुंबई वाले का भी नहीं सभी लोगों का होता है आजकल. This चलता है attitude. You don't think, you don't feel your mind is important. We have all done so many experiments. I have done here growing my hand. Most of you have done growing your finger. Okay? So your mind is already powerful. So when you know, when you feel, and when you are very sure like I am, then you can do your breathing, your belly breathing only with the mind. What you have to do is walking, talking, anything. Like for me, 24 hours I am doing belly breathing, 24 hours I am doing dantian breathing. You only have your mind down in the dantian. Whatever you are doing, there should be an awareness. There you have got such a big brain. And in one tiny area of your brain, you can keep millions and millions of information. And one of those places, 1 million, from those millions, 1 million of information, one small information you keep is that your mind is down in the dantian. And automatically your breath will move down. And you should never forget that. You are eating, eat, be peaceful. Where is the mind? Down. You are walking, let the mind be down. Automatically you will do belly breathing. And not only that, 24 hours a day, I breathe in through my whole body and I breathe out also through my whole body. So there are many ways you can do dantian breathing. If your whole body is breathing, you are having a large area of inhalation and a large area of exhalation. Large area of inhalation brings in large amounts of universal energy. Large area of exhalation removes large amount of toxins from your body. Again, that is also when you are using your mind. Is that right? So, do we have any questions for whatever we have done today? Yes, sir?
Sir, you said about dantian breathing, which you put your hand below the navel and you breathe. This part should move because when I do the breathing, this part moves very easily.
Yeah. This side should move. This should move. You see this? This should move.
This moves very freely.
Yeah. This will move freely for everybody. Okay? Even here, you are just 1 or 2 inches below the diaphragm. So 1 or 2 inches below the diaphragm, feeling the vibration of the breathing is normal. It should come here. Yes, this should move.
For some time we do consciously the dantian.
Yes.
Won't it become the habit without our knowledge? Just goes on.
Yes, it can. It can. Consciously if you do, but you have to be very careful because what happens? People with digestive problems, people with problems of piles, people with problems of the lower abdomen, whatever it may be, reproductive organs, hernia and all those things, if they do it consciously, they may aggravate their problem. Okay, so if you are doing it consciously, like koi log aisa bhi hoga, jinka saans yahan tak, itna gehrai tak ja hi nahi sakta hai un logon ka. So that actually shows that you have a problem in this area below. So for them, if they are going to do it consciously to get the energy or get the prana or the chi to that area, they can do it physically, but then they have to do it very carefully. then I would advise not 5 breaths in a week. So for 1 week continuous only 5 breaths. Jabardasti out and in. Out and in. Only 5 breaths for 1 week. Next week, 2 more breaths. And you should wait at 15 breaths, not more than that. And if you take the 5 breaths and if there is some discomfort in that area, any pain, any discomfort, you should stop doing it for 5 breaths, do it only for 3 breaths. The best is always to use this most powerful mind of yours. It works. It works within seconds. Okay? You know what is the secret to make the mind work? Nobody? Pardon, sir? It is? Yes, it is working already. It is working already. But then we are putting stones in the middle. So the mind is searching for place to move. So what is the secret? I already give you one clue. You are putting stones.
Belief.
Hmm?
Belief.
No, belief, if you know your mind is there, then you already believe it.
Just follow it. Just follow it.
Yeah, you are partly right.
Pardon? Keeping focus lower.
Keeping focus, yes. Obstruction to the power of the mind is your ego and my ego. Always. Always. Sometimes again, remember this. When you feel you are not successful, apne ego ko jara tatolo. See where you are putting your ego in between. And that's why you are not successful. It is always, even you will lose this most powerful energy of the mind when you have your own ego. You know, sometimes when you are in a grave situation, you are not getting any solution to your problem. Most of them, what will you do, you and including me? We will try from all sides. ये कर उसको बुला उसका पहचान निकाल इसका पहचान निकाल ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है वो मदद करेगा ये मदद करेगा है ना यू डू दैट ना ऑल ऑफ अस डू दैट यू शुड नॉट डू दैट डोंट डू एनीथिंग कीप योर स्पाइन स्ट्रेट डू दांतियन ब्रीदिंग फॉर सम टाइम छोड़ दो जस्ट डू दांतियन ब्रीदिंग इफ द कुंडलिनी स्टार्ट्स टू गेट एक्टिवेटेड इफ यू कैन रेज द एनर्जी अप टू द ब्रेन टू द माइंड you will get a solution like this. Or the problem will still remain there, but you will not be stressed. So whenever you are there, again remember, there is ego is one thing. So the stones that you are keeping in the flow of the mind is your ego. Okay? So thank you for being here. Namaste. Please pass it on. Namaste. Please pass it on. Thank you very much for being here. Thank you so much.